بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. أما بعد، we in our book of نحو the Arabic grammar the study and the explanation of the book of الشبراوية. الشبراوية and متن الشبراوية في علم النحو. متن الشبراوية في علم النحو. We have mentioned the structure of the word and قال in the number verse number three قال four I'm sorry أما الكلام اصطلاحا فهو عندهم مركب فيه إسناد كقام علي. أما الكلام اصطلاحا فهو عندهم مركب فيه إسناد كقام علي. Number five. والاسم والفعل ثم الحرف جملتها أجزاؤه فهو عنها غير منتقل. Now we said the structure of the speech in the Arabic language is divided in three categories: al-ismu wal-fi'lu wal-harfu. Al-ismu wal-fi'lu wal-harfu. The noun, the fi'l, the verb, and the harf. And the harf, as we said, you know, this composition of letters that to connect between words. And we have defined الاسم والفعل والحرف. الاسم والفعل والحرف. فقلنا الاسم كلمة دلت على معنى في نفسها واقترنت. الاسم here. كلمة دلت على معنى في نفسها ولم تقترن بزمن. So this is the meaning of الاسم. It's a word that it has a meaning in itself but not associated with time. الفعل كلمة دلت على معنى في نفسها واقترنت بإحدى الأزمنة. بأحد الأزمنة. And a word, the verb is a word, has a meaning in itself and is associated with a time, with a time, with a tense. والحرف كلمة دلت على معنى في غيرها ولم تقترن بزمان. الحرف is a word. It does not have a meaning on its own. Actually, its meaning is only expressed when it is associated with another word. And it's not associated with time, like the verb. Example of harf, example of harf. هل, في, لما, على, ب, إلى, to, for example. هل, هل تفعل كذا؟ Do you do such a thing? ماذا؟ Things like that. ولكل من الاسم والفعل والحرف علامات تميزه. For every one of them, الاسم والفعل والحرف, they have signs. The next verse is going to specify the signs how to know the noun. How to know the verbs and how to know the harf. Up to here, do you have any questions? So you remember the speech, al-kalam, in the Arabic language, is divided in three categories: al-ismu, al-fi'lu, al-harfu. Al-ismu, al-fi'lu, al-harfu. فَالْإِسْمُ يُعْرَفُ بِالتَّنْوِينِ ثم بأل والجر أو بحروف الجر كالرجل. What are the the signs to know the noun. قال التنوين. So the first thing to know the noun. الاسم. علامات الاسم. علامات الاسم. الاسم. الاسم is the noun. Names. الاسم. علامات الاسم. How do I know that this is ism? I mean, how, if I see a word, I say this is an ism. So the ism, we said a word that it has a meaning in itself, but not associated with time. So he gave us like the example of Zaydun. Zaydun is the name. Zaydun. Aliyun. Aliyun. Is a name. So we know Zayd is a name. Huh? So what are the signs to qualify to know that this is a name? So he said, قَالَ فَالْإِسْمُ يُعْرَفُ. So الْإِسْمُ, the noun, is known. يُعْرَفُ. Look, يُعْرَفُ. What it mean, يُعْرَفُ? The noun is known by. يُعْرَفُ. First, قَالَ بِالتَّنْوِينِ. The first one is التنوين. التنوين. What is التنوين? التنوين is this. الضمتين, الفتحتين, الكسرتين, that they call it التنوين. What? So that's the first mark or sign of a noun is التنوين. For example, verb صام. We don't cannot say صامٌ صامٍ. So the ism, every time you see تنوين, that's one of the signs of the nouns. Example: محمدٌ نبيًا رسولٍ. As we said, زيدٌ عليٌ محمدٌ نبيًا Rasulin. So these are Nabiyan. These here call it Tanween. Dun, an, in. That's the Tanween. If you see one of these Tanweens in a word, that's a sign that this is a noun, that this is ism. Yeah? Let me say it in Arabic, okay? This is ism. Ismun. The second قال فالاسم يعرف بالتنوين ثم بأل ثم بأل أل. So the second is أل. أل, the closest in the language English word is D. So أل, you call it أل التعريف, to have the noun known, okay? Al. So if you see something with al, al qamaru, al qamaru. So that's, it's for us a sign that this is word means that it is a noun. Al. As-sama'u, al-ardu, al-rasulu, al-rajulu. Brother. Example, as-sama'u. What is as-sama'u? Huh? The? Ism. But what the meaning of as-sama'u? Okay, this guy. Everyone is doing like this. Studying Arabic now. Al-ardu. Al-ardu. What is al-ardu? The ground, the earth. Al-ard. Al-ard. Al-Rasul. Al-Rasul. The messenger. Al-Rajul. Al-Rajul. The man. Tay. So the second sign of the ism is Al. Al. Al-Qamaru, Al-Sama'u, Al-Ardu, Al-Shamsu. All of that. That's it now. قال the second, the third, the third. قال أو بحروف الر أو بحروف الجر, حروف الجر, حروف الجر, حروف حروف الجر, حروف. Are we giving the definition of حرف? Okay. So the حرف, it expresses its meaning when it associated with another word and is not associated with time. That's the definition of the حرف, as we have mentioned. So for example, حرف إلى, إلى which means to, I go to, أذهب إلى or ذهب to إلى. طيب, these حروف, there is a set of حروف when you associate it to a name, cause the name to be مجرور, مجرور, مجرور. This is we're going to study it, but مجرور, it, you know, the most apparent the meaning of the مجرور to see كسرة. For example, رسول مجرور. رجل قال example in the thing قال كالرجلي, كالرجلي. So this here مجرور الرجلي. So this حرف when it associated enter in the name cause the name to be مجرور, which is mean we're not talking about the effect of this حروف on the noun, but we are seeing what are the signs, the marks to let us know that is noun. If you see one of these letter causing to have the name to be مجرور, so we call it حرف جر. So every time you see حرف جر associated to word, that word must be a name. That's the meaning what we want to study here. He gave an example here. قال all of you know this example. So the حرف الجر enter. Look, بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, رحيم رحمن الله بسم الله. الرحيم. So B, B, باء. الباء حرف جر. This one حرف جر. حرف جر. So look, when we get the B, اسم here, اسمي. So بسمي, it becomes مجرور. We didn't say بسمو, بسمي. Then مضاف, الله. It also cause the مضاف of بسمي, الله, to be مجرورة. And the نعت of Allah also, رحماني رحيمي. And this is an example that it has all the types of جر with one حرف جر. قال يمكن جره بالإضافة أو بحروف الجر أو بالتبعية. So the جر, it will be like add, إضافة, or التبعية by following, you know, the one before it. So we have Allahi, Allahi is majrura. Then Ar-Rahmani, Ar-Rahimi need to be majrura because following Allah, you are describing or giving the attribute of Allah. So Allahi, then comes Rahmani, Rahimi. Ismi is مجرورة with the letter of الجر باء. And اسم الله مجرور بالإضافة. Why we add بسمي, so إضافة اسمي, اسم of who? Of Allah. So the باء it enter to have, and this is a good example that have all the germ. So here when you look at it, you say ismi is a name, Allah is a name or a noun, Ar-Rahman is a noun, Ar-Rahim is a noun. He said, how did you know that? He said, because they accepted, or we have the harf al-jar entered on all of them.
Is there different
ways to analyze it? No. No, we're talking about the noun now. We're not talking about the position of the Rahman or like it being adjective or not.
Allah is the possessor.
It's a noun, it's mudaf.
Yeah, I was on a website and I just seen some other things that said something different. Continue.
The Arabic is one. What is the chapter we're studying here? Studying the nouns, right? What are علامات الاسم. We're not talking about إعراب. علامات الاسم. Okay. علامات الاسم. What it means? علامات. علامات means sign. So how do we know the noun? It's through the signs. So again, بيت number 6. قال فالاسم يعرف بالتنوين ثم بأل والجر أو بحروف الجر كالرجل. Al-Jarri is like when you have it like under Kasra comes like an apparent Jar. So Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim give us the example of all the type of the Jar. We have Harfu Jar, Ismi, Allahi, Mudaf, An At-Taba'iyya, Na'at of Allahi, Ar-Rahmani, Ar-Rahim. So this is give us an example of all the type of Jar in Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. And this too give us the size of the name. What? Yes. Idafa is to mudafun. Mudafun is to add. So ism bismi. I say bismi. Allah is the mudaf. So mudaf. So I added Allah to specify the name of who. So the jar here, the jar caused by the idafa, not caused by the harf jar. Because idafa the adding, mudaf to add, and idafa is to add. Naam, exactly. Mudaf ilayh, and the mudaf ilayh is majroor because of the idafa. So mudafun ilayh is the name. The action of mudafun ilayh is name idaf. Okay. So mudaf ilayh is like adding to it. The adding the translation is idaf. Allahi idaf. Ar-Rahmani is na'at to Allah. Description attribute. So tabaiyah, following. Like in Surah Amma, jaza'an min rabbika, min rabbika. بعد what he said. Ar-Rahmani, la yamlikun. Ar-Rahmani maksura. Maksura ala ايه? Why maksura? Because mudaf for min rabbika ata'an. Min rabbika jaza'an. Then he said ar-Rahmani. In some other qira'at, tibda bil mubtada, iqul ar-Rahmanu. But when it's mudaf, qala alif lam ra, kitabun anzalay, litukhrija an-nasa min adh-dhulumati ila an-nur. Ila sirati. العزيز الحميد الله الذي له صح ولا لا الله so that's تبع is following the description of the sirat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sirat al-aziz al-hamid, Allahi. So that's by tabai. Yeah. Yes. 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 Ba is harf jar. Yes. No, ismi is the al-harf al-majrur. Al-ism al-majrur. Harf jar is ba. So the majrur, he the noun associated or connected to the harf jar. The example that he gave in the thing, كالرجلي, كالرجلي, ك, also play the harf of jar. Wait, the tashbih, ولكن has the effect of jar. كالرجلي. في الداري, in the house, في الداري, في الداري. You can open any ayah from the Quran, you'll find a lot of examples. سبحان الذي أسرى بعبده بعبده عبده بعبده مجرورة. Then عبد is a noun, cannot be a verb. Okay. من المسجد الحرام المسجد من حرف جر المسجد مجرور الحرام مضاف. The kasra is the asli. There's other khafd or jar far'i. Depends on the structure of the word. Kasra is the most known asliya. I mean, the asliya, which is when you're talking about jar, is kasra. But not always kasra. But let's go step by step. This one, this bait is explaining the signs of the name. So let's limit it to that. What are the signs of the name? Tanwinun al wajar aw bihuruf al jar. والجر أو بحروف الجر. فالاسم يعرف بالتنوين ثم بأل والجر أو بحروف الجر. واضح؟ There is two other signs that the author, because he given a very concise book that he didn't mention. قال, which we add then for النداء, 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 حرف النداء. When you say to someone, يَا, يَا أَرْضُ, يَا مُوسَى, يَا. So the نداء, the structure or the form of a nida, also that's of the specification of the nouns. So the fourth is a nida. The fourth is a nida. A nida is to calling, like ya, ya ardu. ابلعي ماءك يا سماء أقلعي يا سماء يا إبراهيم أعرض عن هذا يا. So that's يا. النداء is only you know specify one of the specification of the name. The fifth one we call it الإسناد إليه. الإسناد إليه. Al-isnadu, it means to describe, described. Okay. You cannot describe a verb. You know, for example, that it will becomes masdar. Well, I can hear al-isnadu ilayh, like for example, say Zaydun qa'imun. Zaydun is standing. So when you give a description, will be what we give a description to is a noun, describing the state or something. So those are five. Three mentioned in the bait and two we add them. The two that we add, al-nida'u and al-isnadu ilayh. Yeah, yeah. Al-isnadu ilayh, al-ikhbaru, to describe or give a description. And whatever you give description to, that's a sign that he's a noun. طيب, number seven, bait number seven. والفعل بالسين أو قد أو بسوف وإن أردت حرفا. Okay, this is والفعل. What are the signs of the verb? When it accept, or you can connect with it, seen. When you can connect with it, seen. Like سأفعلُ, سنفعلُ, سأصومُ, سأصلي. قد. Also قد only can be connected with verbs. قد صليت. قد سمع الله قول التي تجادلك في زوجها. قد. And سوف will. سوف أفعل. I will do it. سوف. So the verb differ from the noun with these three characteristics. That he'll accept. What do you mean accept? You can connect with it. Seen, قد, سوف. I'm going to explain. The first قال السين. السين وسوف are only connected with the فعل in مضارع. الفعل المضارع. الفعل المضارع is the فعل that is in the tense of present and future. الفعل المضارع. السين is name حرف استقبال. السين حرف استقبال. When you connect the سين to the verb, it means I'm going to do it soon. استقبال. سأفعله. سوف extend the time in the future. سأفعل سوف أفعل. So seen and سوف only can be connected with the فعل مضارع, the verb مضارع. And you know the مضارع. قال السين تسمى حرف استقبال وحرف تنفيس. وتنفيس is mean وحرف تنفيس أي توسيع. It's like you giving like an opening, you know. سوف أفعله. It's like you permit me to give me a little bit more time. أفعل. I'm doing it now. سأفعل. سين استقبال تنفيس. سوف give you more time. So the difference between seen and سوف it give you more extended time. Give you time shorter than سوف. So seen it moving the action from a restricted time to an extended time. سوف to a more extended time. That's why called تسويف. When you come to the obedience of Allah, the تسويف is causing to, leading to sins, leading to heedlessness. Someone say the tawbah is a request to be done immediately or to delay it. Tawbah immediately. So the one who said sa'atubu, I will. The other one say sawfa'atubu. So he made it like in a far future. So he said the taswif is wrong. That we call it taswif, postponing. So it comes from this word sawfa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala qala sayaqulu as-sufaha min an-nas. They are going to say. Ibrahim qala inni dhahibun ila rabbi sayahdin. He's going to guide. In a farther future, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned qala innal ladhina kafaru bi ayatina sawfa nuslihim nar. Those who denied our ayat, we're going to cast them wal'iyadu billahi in her fire. Sawfa. See, sawfa is gonna come. وَأَنَّ سَعْيَهُ سَوْفَ يُرَى. The third one is قَدْ. And القَدْ can be connected to both past and مضارع. فعل ماضي ومضارع. قد سمع أن قد تفيد التحقيق. قد it's دلالة. It means التحقيق like the confirmation of the action. قد سمع. So Allah indeed had listened to your conversation. قد سمع. تحقيق. Confirmation, certainty of the action. قال قد نرى. This is نرى is مضارع. So قد نرى تقلب وجهك في السماء قد يعلم الله المعوقين منكم. So قد can be associated to both ماض and مضارع. مضارع is not present. We call it مضارع because the مضارع is both present and future. Yes, command, we're going to come just the next one. So we said, وَالْفِعْلُ بِالسِّينِ أَوْ قَدْ وَبِسْأَوْ بِسَوْفَ. The command is known by its form, which is a request, a command, by its form of command. قال والفعل الأمر. They call it فعل أمر. فعل أمر. فعل أمر. واضح. Imperative form يعرف بدلالته على الطلب كقوله تعالى وأقيموا الصلاة. Like Allah سبحانه وتعالى say establish prayer. أقيموا. أقيموا that you know that is a command. So the form of it is the imperative form. So these are the three signs as mentioned. Add to it the command form. Because the name or the noun cannot have a command form. So whatever comes in a command form, that's a verb. Whatever word has seen before it, قد, سوف, is a verb, is fair. So this is here what he said in verse 7, والفعل بالسين أو قد أو بسوف أو بسوف. والفعل, the verb, is known by having connected to it the letter seen or the word قد or the word سوف. وإن أردت حرفا فمن تلك الأمور خلي. And when we talk about حرف, the word that is حرف, he does not have any of what we have mentioned. So no tanween, no al, no jar, no nida, no isnad, no seen, no qad, no sawf, and no command. All what we have mentioned as signs, what specify the nouns and what specify the verb that we just mentioned, in the harf he doesn't have them. So the harf, he doesn't have any of the specification of the verb. So if you want to apply the signs of the harf and it does not connect, and of the noun this, then you say this is a harf. And the harf is known because, as we said, it only has a meaning when you associate it to another word. And is not associated to time. That's the harf. وَأَمَّا الْحَرْفُ فَيَمْتَازُ بِخُلُوِّهِ عَنْ عَلَامَاتِ الْإِسْمِ وَالْفَعْلِ. So the harf, he cannot accept neither the signs of the noun nor of the fi'l. واضح. Any question here? واضح.
We're talking about the verbs have three columns, right? And in order to identify verbs, they have to have three fathas on them. Is that right?
No. Talking of the signs who make us know that is a verb. This word, we have a word. You see a word.
Yeah.
I'm gonna tell you this is a noun or a verb or a harf. هل هذا اسم أو فعل أو حرف. So to know them, there's a signs. This is what he's describing. Say. If I see tanween, then is a noun. If I see L, then is a noun. Okay. If I see ya of a nida, that is a noun. If he's majroor, that is a noun. Or accept the jar. If I see sin associated to it, sawfa, qad, or being in a form of imperative command, so this is a verb. So it's like we are defining the identity of the categories making the language in the Arabic. Al-Kalam, what is the speech? The speech are divided into noun, ism, fi'l, wa harf. What are the differences between them? Everyone has his identity. We are defining the identity of every one of them by the specification, by these signs. Okay? But has three fatha or things that depends on the verb, so that's inshallah an advanced chapter. طيب as a conclusion, I read the conclusion here for it here. قال الكلمة في اصطلاح النحويين اللفظ الموضوع وضعا عربيا لمعنى مفرد. The word in the terminology of the نحويين, the scholar of نحو, it's a لفظ, the word that it been put together according to the Arabic structure for a specific meaning. الكلام في اصطلاح النحويين, speech in the terminology or the definition of the scholar of نحو, is اللفظ المركب المفيد فائدة يحسن السكوت عليها, is structures or combined words, they have a meaning or they convey a meaning, and someone or like when you read it, there's when you stop on it, it complete the meaning. Yeah. So when you stop on it, it has give you complete meaning. ينقسم الكلام إلى ثلاثة أقسام. The speech is divided in three categories. اسم فعل وحرف. Again, اسم ما دل على معنى في نفسه ولم يقترن بزمن. الاسم is the noun, which a word that has meaning in itself but is not associated to a time, so it will not affected by the time, like a name Zayd. Allahu Akbar. ba fi'l ma dalla ala ma'na fi nafsihi wa iqtarana bi ahad al azminati al thalatha. Al fi'l, the verb, it's a word that has meaning in itself and is can be affected by time, you know, so he's associated to one of the time or form. الحرف, as we said, كلمة دلت على معنى في غيرها ولم تقترن بزمن. A word that will have a meaning when it's associated to another word and is not associated to a tense. علامات الاسم, what are the signs of the ism? That he can be majrur, tanween, al, and nidas. Those are the four main ones. Five, ينقسم الفعل, the verb can be is divided into ماض ومضارع وأمر. Past, مضارع, which is like present and future, وأمر, imperative form or command, verbs that imply command. وعلامة الفعل الماضي والمضارع, and the signs of the فعل, the verb in the ماضي tense or مضارع tense, is to accept قد. So you can associate or connect with it the word قد, like قد سمع, قد نرى, قد يعلم إلى آخره. وعلامة المضارع, أن المضارع, the verb in the مضارع tense, will can associate or connect with it the letter seen, the letter سوف. وفعل الأمر يدل على الطلب, and فعل الأمر يدل على الطلب, the verb it has like the imperative form of the verb, it imply or means like a command. طلب is like a request, command, order, request. طيب. The next bab is الإعراب. الإعراب. إعراب. So this is actually, this is the heart of the Nahu. This is the objective of the knowledge of the Nahu is al-i'rab. 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 الإعراب. إعراب. Should not write it. إيرابس. I think that's violation. إيراب. الإعراب، هذا والإعراب تغيير الأواخر من اسم وفعل أتى من بعد ذي عمل. So the objective of the knowledge of the Nahu is al-i'rab. And al-i'rab is the language, it means changing. هو التغيير. Things change. So أعربت معدة البعير, as he mentioned here. And also al-i'rab has the meaning of clarifying. Clarifying. Like قال أعربت, for example, someone he's saying أعربت عما بنفسي. I get out of everything I want to say. أعربت. So what is الإعراب? And then we go pray inshallah. هو تغيير أواخر الكلم لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها. الإعراب is how these names or verbs will change its end. Why بسم الله not الله, الرحمن not الرحمن, not الرحمن. So the end of the words, they change. Okay, the changing of the end of the word depends on the effect that being inflicted on those words. Okay, that's what we call al-amil. What the effect that change the state of that noun or the state of that verb. So the changing of the states is expressed by the haraka, or we can say expressed by the end of these words, is either noun or verb. This action, all of it called i'rab, is called i'rab. هو تغيير أواخر الكلم لاختلاف العوامل الداخلة عليها. تغيير, changing the end of the words because of the different action inflicted on it or associated to it. Okay, like ذهب علي إلى المدرسة. Why علي and مدرستي? So the عامل of علي is ذهب. What have علي to be مرفوع is the action of going, ذهب. What have إلى المسجد, what have المسجد to be مجرورة. The عامل of إلى caused المسجد to be مجرور. واضح. So مسجد مكسورة. Why مكسورة? By explaining it, that what we call إعراب. To explain to me why is مكسورة, that's the إعراب. Why علي مرفوعة, that is the إعراب. رأيت عليا. I don't say رأيت علي or علي. رأيت, I saw. So sowing تعدي to علي made it to be منصوب. So the changing of the end of the words based on the action that affected it, that is the إعراب. We're not doing calculus here, guys. I'm seeing the face. طيب, with some review, inshallah, it will be easy. What? We'll go pray and we'll.